This is Raymond for RPad.TV here with a review of the Aqua by Footoon by UVO system. This is a bottom coil silica atomizer that offers outstanding flavor, really good versatility when it comes to juice flow and airflow, and excellent build quality. A lot of people out there are touting this atomizer as the K-Fun killer. I disagree with that assessment. It's a different kind of vape than what the K-Fun offers, but it is an excellent, excellent atomizer nonetheless. Especially if you like airier draws or if you want a dual coil, the Aqua is right for you. Now, before I continue with the review, I wanted to give a shout out to the Vape Source for hooking me up with this review Aqua. Now let's get on to the review. The Aqua atomizer comes in a black decorative box. The latch is magnetized and the UVO system is on the top of the box. It includes a couple of accessories that are quite useful. First up are the extra O-rings. Extra O-rings are always a good idea, and you have quite a few here. Next is this small pin. This pin allows you to use the Aqua in hybrid mode with the Origin by Footoon mod. Last is a pair of drip tips. These drip tips match the Aqua perfectly, but they are all metal, so if you like to go sub-ohms, they do get quite hot. In my experience, they were fine for everything above 1 ohm, but as you get to 0.7 ohms and lower, they become too warm if you're a chain vapor. At 0.5 ohms and lower, yeah, forget about it. I mean, you need an insulated drip tip or a glass drip tip if you want a chain vape, in my opinion. Build quality on the Aqua is really, really, really good. It's made from 316 stainless steel, which is considered surgical grade steel. So it has a nice heft to it and a very luxurious feel. Design-wise, it has these rings that perfectly match the Origin by Footoon mod. The diameter is 21 millimeters, which is a little bit atypical. The Origin is a 21 millimeter mod, so it was made to line up with that perfectly. But most mods on the market are 22 millimeter. There are several 23 millimeter mods. So you do have a little gap here for when you're using it with other mods. Personally, I didn't mind that at all because I love the way this thing vapes, but I know some vapers that are really particular about getting a totally flush line, totally flush appearance. So the 21 millimeter diameter could bother them. Here's a look at the bare deck of the Aqua. As you can see, there's not a ton of space to work with. So if you're a newcomer to rebuildables, maybe this isn't the best choice for you. It is trickier to build than a rebuildable dripper, but if you're an experienced builder, then this should be no problem. I do recommend building with wire over ribbon. Personally, I prefer using ribbon, but it was too difficult for me because of the lack of space and the lack of post holes. I have seen some flat ribbon builds on the Aqua, but it's not something that I can do personally, and I think that a lot of people would have problems doing that. Here is the Aqua all wicked up. I really preferred using this with dual coils. You can use it with single coils, but the airflow always felt a little funky to me. If you're going with a single coil setup, then I recommend the K-Fun over this, but if you're looking for something that's easy to dual coil, the Aqua is absolutely a great choice. You can dual coil a K-Fun, but it is difficult. Dual coiling on the Aqua is much easier. Now, let's assemble this. I'll show you how it works. Here is the brass pin here. If you're using this in hybrid mode, then you use the pin that I showed you earlier, but for all other mods, you will need this cap here with the 510 connection. Here's the dome that goes over the coils. As you can see, it has a small flavor chamber, so you get excellent, excellent flavor out of this. Here's the tank. It has the logo on one side and your serial number on the other. refilling the Aqua is really easy. You put your juice in the tank, fill it up, and then you screw the top cap on. And when it's almost closed, you turn it upside down to pressurize it. It's very fast and easy to refill. You can do something similar on K-Fun atomizers, but the way that you're supposed to refill it with the K-Fun 3.1, you need a needle tip bottle or a syringe. The K-Fun Light, you have to take off the atomizer and use a screwdriver. But this is the way you're supposed to refill the Aqua. It's something simple and fast, and I've done it several times when I was drunk, so that's how easy it is. The Aqua is a very versatile atomizer as well. Up here you can see the two air holes to adjust airflow. You just twist the tank. Turning it clockwise gives you a tighter draw. Turning it counterclockwise opens up the airflow. You get a pretty broad range of airflow. It's a lot airier than the highest settings that a K-Fun will give you. You can also adjust the juice flow here by turning the dome. It opens up counterclockwise. I didn't have to use this feature using 50-50 or 60-40 PG-VG juices, but if you like high VG juices, juices that are thicker, then the juice flow control can be a really handy feature. So I really love the versatility of the Aqua. In addition to outstanding flavor, you have a pretty broad set of airflow and juice flow options. The Aqua is undoubtedly an excellent atomizer. It's especially great for juices that work well at higher temperatures, bakery vapes, certain dessert vapes, and tobacco juices. Those are all excellent choices for the Aqua because of the heat potential of the dual coil builds. Now for the K-Fun versus Aqua debate, personally, I don't think it's a debate at all. They have different strengths and weaknesses. For single coil setups and for juices that work well at cooler temperatures, I always go for the K-Fun or K-Fun style atomizers. For juices that work well at higher temperatures, like the ones I mentioned earlier, and for when I want a dual coil, the Aqua is the way to go. It's relatively easy to make dual coil builds on the Aqua. As for price, I've seen the Aqua as low as $170, so it is an expensive product, but it's in line with what other high-end atomizers cost. To me, the price is absolutely worth it. I think it's a great product, and I love having it along with the K-Fun in my collection. Like I said, they're different types of vapes. So if you're looking for an airier draw, if you're looking for a hotter vape, the Aqua is an excellent, excellent choice. Once again, special thanks to the Vape Source for hooking me up with this Aqua, and there are lots more details in my text review of the Aqua by Footoon, so head on over to the vaping section of RPad.TV for the full story. Thanks for watching.